Hey guys, Scott Herman, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a closer look at dumbbell shrugs versus rack pulls to help you not only better understand these exercises, but spark more growth in your traps as well. And guys, these are more than just up and down exercises. So if you've been incorporating them into your workouts and haven't seen much in terms of gains, you're most likely doing something wrong. But first things first, so why are we comparing these two exercises? Well, let's first take a quick look at the anatomy of the traps to try to better understand them. So your traps are actually much larger than what you see on the sides of your neck, and they're a powerful muscle group as well. What you see right here, these are just your upper traps. The actual trapezius muscle is much longer and goes down your thoracic spine. More specifically, you have your superior or upper fibers, your upper traps, which originate in your cervical spine and insert in the posterior border of your clavicle bone. And these are the fibers mainly responsible for shrugging or bringing your shoulders closer to your ears. Then you have the middle fibers of the traps, which originate a bit lower in the cervical spine as well as the thoracic vertebrae and insert into the acromion as well as your scapula. And finally, the inferior or lower fibers of the traps originate a lot lower on your thoracic spine and insert near the scapula as well. But why am I telling you all of this? Well, it's because knowing more about your traps will help you understand how to adjust your form to target specific sections of your traps versus just being stuck in the same vertical movement patterns all the time. But the main takeaway here is that your traps are not only responsible for controlling the scapula, but also stabilizing your spine. This is why even an exercise like a deadlift is beneficial for trap training, because you'll have to heavily recruit your traps to stabilize your scapula and spine when performing the movement. So now that you know a bit more about the traps, let's take a closer look at the dumbbell shrug and rack pull and see how to best utilize these exercises for traps training. First up is the dumbbell shrug. Now, this exercise can obviously be performed with a barbell as well, and the main advantage is that you'll be able to lift a much heavier load. But how much you lift isn't always the goal. Remember that range of motion plays a big role in muscle activation, and dumbbells offer a bit more when it comes to which area of the traps you want to focus on. For example, you can both barbell and dumbbell shrug vertically with heavy weight to keep the focus of the movement on targeting the upper traps. But if you want to bring a bit more mid-traps activation, dumbbells allow you to safely lean forward and bring the load of the weight to the sides of your body as you shrug. In fact, one of my favorite variations of the dumbbell shrugs is a seated version where you lean forward slightly and focus on both scapular retraction and elevation, targeting both mid and upper traps. As for weight, believe it or not, slow and controlled is not always the answer. That might be the way you start training to build a solid and safe foundation for training, but as you progress, using a bit of momentum becomes very beneficial when trying to overload the traps or squeeze out those last few extra reps. Remember that your traps are designed to help stabilize your shoulders. So as long as you're able to control the negative, don't be afraid to boost the weight. Maybe even pick up some lifting straps from my friends over at Iron Bull Strength. This way you don't have to worry about your grip giving out before your set is over. But whether you're using straps or just your hands, do not bounce the weight. And this is where most guys go wrong with shrugs and why they don't see many gains from them. They go way too fast with the reps and completely miss out on the stretch at the bottom of the movement. So if that's you, really slow things down and let the dumbbells pull your shoulders down on every rep. Feel those traps stretching and know the weighted stretch is going to play a big role in breaking down your muscle fibers to help you with traps growth. And speaking of the stretch, this brings us to the rack pulls. But before we dive in, be sure to tap that like button and drop a comment below. Your comments can be anything, guys. It doesn't matter. Just as long as you do it and feed the YouTube monster what it wants to boost the YouTube algorithm. So get to it. All right, the rack pull. You know, I bet since talking about this exercise in previous videos, many of you still haven't even really added it to your weekly training. Some of you might even just feel silly or weird taking up an entire squat rack just to move a heavy load a few inches for reps. But that's the exercise, and it certainly has its benefits in terms of traps growth and helps stabilizing your spine. Like I said earlier, even exercises like the deadlift are beneficial for traps training because you'll have to heavily recruit your traps to help stabilize your spine and scapula throughout the movement. Well, the rack pull is essentially a shortened version of the deadlift, allowing you to focus solely on the top portion of the lockout, which is all you really need to isolate and stretch those traps. This also means that because we're skipping the deadlift portion of the movement, you'll be able to overload your traps with a lot more weight. But this isn't a quick up and down slam movement, guys. The goal here is to brace your core, pull the weight, and sit in that stretch for a solid 2 to 3 seconds on every single repetition. Also, make sure your shoulders are neutral. This means that they're not retracted and they're not rolled forward. And lift the weight by pushing through your legs and hips. It's really easy to turn this into a lower back lift if you're new to the exercise, so be aware of that on every single rep. So now the big question, which of these two exercises should you incorporate into your training? Well, depending on the program you're training with, you might have to get a bit creative in how you incorporate these movements. For example, if you're training with the traditional split of two muscle groups a day, then having both exercises as standalone movements isn't really an issue, as you'll have plenty of time to hit them both. But if you're training with a full body or upper lower split, your time is a bit more limited. As for me, I'm currently training with a traditional split and have a day where I only train traps, shoulders, and abs. So my workouts will start usually with a heavy rack pull of about 5 sets of 6 to 8 reps. And then as I progress through the workout, I'll utilize the barbell version of the shrug to load my upper traps a bit more. And then I'll do a bent over seated version of the dumbbell shrug toward the end of my training to place a bit more emphasis on the mid traps. And I usually do around 3 to 4 sets of 6 to 8 reps for each exercise. But if time is a bit more limited, like when training with a full body program, it wouldn't be uncommon for me to again overload my traps with heavy rack pulls and then superset the rack pulls with bent over seated dumbbell shrugs. However, this time around, I would go a bit higher on the volume for the shrugs. An example would be 4 sets of 6 to 8 reps on rack pulls, followed by 10 to 12 reps on the bent over dumbbell shrugs. Be sure to check out the rest of my Versus Series playlist over here. And if you missed my latest video, you can check that out too. And more importantly, if you're in need of a new workout program or meal plan, click this link to go directly to my program selector tool. I have loads of home and gym workouts, and this tool will help you find the exact program that fits your goals. And as always, more good stuff coming soon. See you guys.